Hello and welcome. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you all about state properties and how to use them so that when the values in these state properties change, your app's user interface will adapt and change and update automatically. All right, let's dive in. Hi, my name is Chris, and if this is your first time here, welcome to Code with Chris, where we teach beginners how to make an app even if you've never coded before. Now, before we dive into state properties, I have a quick question for you. How are you liking SwiftUI so far? Let me know by leaving a comment below, and on your way down there, if you wouldn't mind, please give this video a quick like. It really helps me out. Thank you. All right, with that said, let's get started. State is a very easy concept to understand. Essentially, it's a piece of data that the user interface depends on. Let's say you're looking at a photo and this app has the ability to heart a photo that you like. So you might have a state property that keeps track of whether this photo is hearted or not by the user. If the state is set to false, then the user interface will display an empty heart. If the state is set to true, then the UI will display a filled heart. So let's go into Xcode now and I'll show you how easy it is to implement this. Now here we have the SwiftUI project from the previous lesson, and we're going to build upon this to demonstrate state properties. If you didn't build this project from the previous lesson, not to worry, you can find this starter project in the resources for this lesson. However, if you did build this project from lesson 3, then you can go ahead, feel free to use yours. Let's describe what we're going to do in terms of state properties here. So I'm going to put a heart button here between the image and the text that the user can tap on to toggle whether they like this photo or not. And depending on that state, we're going to have that heart icon change to a filled heart or an empty heart to reflect that status. And we're also going to have a count in terms of the number of likes or hearts. Now, let's start by adding the heart icon in between this pink building image and the text. So here I've got my VStack, and I'm going to do that right here. Now, rather than adding my own image assets for the heart, we can use something called SF symbols. Without getting too much into it, because I wanna dive deeper into it in the next lesson, I'll just say that SF symbols is a collection of icons and symbols that you can use. It comes packaged with iOS 13 and you can just use them. They're very helpful. So you gotta take it at face value here and just copy what I do. In the next lesson, I'll dive a little deeper into how you use them and what they are and what you can do with them. All right, so you start with an image, but we're gonna use the system name or named system name initializer. And we're gonna pass in the name of the symbol. So I'm just gonna say heart, and you're instantly gonna see that heart icon there. That's just part of the system. I didn't have to add that as an asset. Now there's a different one called heart.fill, and it's essentially the same icon, but filled in. Now this is just a static image icon right here. We wanna make this dependent on some sort of state, right? So let's go ahead and declare our first state property. We're gonna do it right under this content view struct here before the body. And the magical keyword we use is at capital S state, and that's going to indicate a new state property. Use the var keyword just like a normal property, and you give it a name. I'm going to call this isHearted, and I'm going to set it to false. Now, one thing that you want to do, it's a recommended practice, is actually to make it a private property. And the reason for this is because state properties are really meant to describe the state of this particular view, which is content view. If you have a piece of data or a property which you want multiple views to depend on, there are other mechanisms to do that. That wouldn't be using a state property. So we can get into those later on in the series. But for now, we're looking at state properties. And the reason why we make it private is just to reinforce the fact that it's only accessible by content view. And that's what happens when you use this private keyword access modifier. So that's why we put private there, just to reinforce that. All right, so what were we doing here? Okay, so we've declared our state property isHearted, and we're gonna make this icon depend on that. Very simply, we're just gonna use an if statement. If isHearted, you know, is true, then we're gonna display this heart. Let's see what happens here, because it is set to false. So this is not going to trigger. If you hit resume, you'll see that it disappears, right? Because this is false. So it's not going to have this image element here. But if I add an else clause and I show an empty heart instead, when that is false, then we're going to see an empty heart, right? Because this state is false, right? So it's going into this branch and showing this. So let me set this to true and resume it. And it is filled in. Now that's not too amazing, right? Because I'm manually changing the state here through code. It's basically just toggling between these two branches of the if statement. But however, let's say we change that heart into a button. I'm going to declare a new button. So let's go ahead and do that. And for the action, we are going to toggle the isHearted property. When you call the toggle method, in case you haven't used this, it just toggles it between true or false. So it changes its state. Now for the label here, I'm going to get rid of this. And for the label of the button, it's just going to be this code right here. So the actual image of the button is going to depend on the state. All right, so now let me just run this project so that we can play around with it in the simulator. And another thing you can do is actually use the live preview, but I'm already building it right there. All right, so we've got our UI here. It is hearted. If I tap on it, it toggles the state property is hearted to false. And this image of the button is going to change by itself. See, I didn't have to manually tell the button to change its image. All I had to do was toggle the state. Hit it again, it toggles the state and the image of the button changes automatically. Now, this is one illustration of using state as a Boolean, but state can also be an integer. It can be anything. So I'm going to show you an example of a state, and I'm going to call this num hearts. I'm going to make this 999. And I'll set this back to false. Okay, so now we're using state as an integer. And so what I want to do is show the count beside the heart. And what we're going to do here is we're going to declare a horizontal stack. We're going to put the button inside of it. And then we're also going to have the count. So I'm going to have a text which is going to be the num hearts. The problem is that num hearts is an integer, and in order to display it inside a text element, I'm going to have to convert it to a string. So let's go ahead and create a string from that. And I'm going to hit resume, and we should see the label right beside it. All right, let me just try running this project. All right, so I've got 999, nothing happens, obviously, because we haven't added the code yet. But what if I add the code to increase or decrease the count whenever I toggle it? So I'm going to change that code right here. So when I toggle it, I'm going to add some additional code. I mean, it's starting to look pretty messy. So actually, I'm just going to re-indent everything. I'm going to select everything, go into editor, go into structure and hit re-indent. If you didn't know about this, this is the shortcut key or the menu item. Tap on that. It's just going to make everything nice and tidy for you. All right, now we're going to say, you know, if self is hearted, then we are going to say num hearts is plus equal one. It's going to add one to the number of hearts. Else, we're going to minus one. And the reason for that is because you are unhearting something, so you're removing a vote, essentially. So let me run this project again in the simulator. All right, so when I tap on this now, it's actually going to toggle this to true, and it's going to increase that number of hearts to 1,000. And we're gonna see that this text increases automatically. In UIKit, in order to do this, I would have had to set the text property of this label to 1,000, you know, to the updated count. But in SwiftUI, because we're using state properties, all I need to do is update the property, and all of the pieces of the UI that depend on those property that are listening to changes for those properties, they just update themselves automatically. That's how great and easy that is to do. Now, I have a challenge for you guys, and that is to change this text down here. If the image is hearted, then I want you to just have this amazing text that we have here. But if it is not hearted, then I want you to use some basic text or some very sad, pathetic looking text. Use some small font or something like that. But if it's hearted, then we're gonna make this bold, pink, and amazing. Like, I think this is pretty pink, bold, and amazing, but you can make it even more amazing if you'd like, just to get some extra practice in with using state properties. So in this lesson, you learn all about state properties and how you can have your user interface update automatically when the values change. In the next lesson, I'll show you what SF symbols are and some of the cool things that you can do with them. If you enjoyed this lesson, please hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications as well so that you don't miss the next video when it comes out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.